Daniel's definitely going Pikachu. They're going to do a hand warmer. Okay. Welcoming Bard to the mic. So how are you doing, Bard?
Hi, guys. I'm good.
Do you hear me okay?
I hear you great.
I'll have to speak up probably a little bit. I know that mic. Cody had to switch with me earlier, but if you hear me, then that's great. I hear you fine.
All right, let's see what's going on.
Some hand warmers right now. I wish I could have sat down with someone from Team Phoenix. I don't know where Freeing went, but man. When have you and Marbles ever teamed doubles? Not just like tournament, but friendlies or anything?
No. Okay. We've never.
No chemistry.
It's sort of just a last minute thing. I played with him in singles, and I know his relative skill level, and so I thought it'd be fun. And I think we have decent synergy. We need to work a lot on it and our tactics a little bit.
You guys did great. You guys had great key moments.
Yeah.
Clutch moments.
Yeah. Is that Cam on? Am I?
yeah, but it's not on us. He's not watching. Oh, okay. The stream's not on us. The stream is on the.
Okay. Well, in any case.
Mad Rush might mess with us and put it on us every once in a while.
So, Schmirk and that's Jimmy Joe versus.
Tan Womers are up. They're going into it. We have 4
P. Oh,
yeah. All right. We're not going to talk. I'm not calling this match. I'm not calling it.
Let's see. So, Jimmy.
Oh, my
gosh. Wow. That is nuts.
Cody Daniels is definitely Pikachu.
Wow, that was great. Just love the wall.
Bracket, do you and Marbles know who you play? And Loser?
I have no idea.
Okay.
No idea. So they're fighting comfortably separately, now they're coming back together.
Daniel uses the stock. Oh no, Stranded uses the stock.
Surprised he didn't steal that. I guess he had to look out for his opponent. That's one thing in doubles I've noticed is like when you're trying to secure an edge guard, even if the opponent dies, you have to look out for his opponent.
When your opponent's dying, you have to go for ledge, is that what you're saying?
I'm saying, like, when you're trying to edge guard your opponent, and it's a 2-1, or it's even a 1-1 situation with the opponent comes back and it's it changes, it's like a huge difference, obviously, between singles and doubles gameplay tactics. So that's. That was a nice little exchange. So now they're separated.
Neutral's everything.
Yeah, they did a good job, I think, of splitting when necessary and then immediately coming back together to protect each other from the opponent.
Correct, yeah. Everyone here is going to know to go for the 2v1 instead of the ledge guard, I feel like.
Yeah.
Unless it's like an easy ledge guard. Like
yeah.
Grabbing ledge. And
right. You try to save him. Immediately, like trying to come back together. It's pretty close.
It's
and they're securing the edge right here, stranded to Cody.
Can't be missing these aerial moves.
What was that?
Red team's missing these aerials. Jimmy Joe is missing these up aerials.
See, I guess that worked out for him. I might have gone for the grab. And the risk you take, of course, in grab is, you know, getting hit by the other one.
No.
But up smash has a lot of hit lag, so I feel it's a bit risky. I don't know why I waited there. But... that's nice. I like how I think that smirk protected the edge guard.
Strong game one from Team Daniels. That's about. Oh. It was over.
I chose to not. I don't know. There we go.
All ODS right. 3. ODS 3, here we are.
I was gonna say that. I played Jimmy Joe at Genesis 5.
Okay.
The first, I think the first, maybe second time in bracket, and he has a really good neutral.
Loser side?
We were D1. I don't know, I guess it might have been loser. It wasn't. And then Schmirk, I've played him recently, and he's improved a ton. He was always pretty good, but he's gotten, sharpened up a lot since then. So let's see if they can bring it back this game.
I don't know why I thought Schmirk used Mario. Schmirk used Mario.
That happens a lot. So I really like that set. That's one thing about Kirby.
It's a smarter choice. I like that choice. This is a easier matchup to watch. Easier to call. Staying, he was staying behind Stranded more. He should be in front.
Yeah, I kind of like taking the aerial, even double. But, oh, that was a nice break. Was going the opposite way. I think he could have. I would have gone for maybe a double up B.
That's Kirby. Yeah. That's Kirby, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's granted, you have to be careful because you don't have all the time for two people playing, but I think he was so
oh. Yeah, Stranded.
I like he's trying to cover the highlight. So they were covering. I made it back with faster. I was discussing earlier with my team Marbles that I think F-Smash is a little safer in doubles just because
risky in doubles.
Yeah. No, I think it's safer because in singles with the end lag, an opponent anticipates it like correct, but in doubles like you hopefully like your opponent. You know, busy doing something, and so Smash can cover a lot of.
Okay.
Yeah. Now that's just my little bleed.
Kill. Kill. Yeah.
A good double lightning.
Good.
I
well,
like
let's
that.
Go to game three. Let's great go to game three.
There you go.
Daniels loses his stock. Daniels doesn't need to be going for the ledge. Strand needs to go for the ledge.
Yeah, so there, Cody was hogging ledge, denying that option. And then,
they split them up, they got the split, they got the long split. Not as close as it was a minute ago.
Wow. Strand is recovering. Plenty of time.
Saves Daniels. Oh, Daniels doesn't save himself. Down there.
Something.
Ah, he should have nared.
Yeah, that should be
it. That's it.
Okay, so a healthy lead here.
So we're looking at a 2-0 from Daniel Stranded.
I think my mic got turned up. Okay.
Thanks to Dark Horse.
Sorry, I'm very quiet. All right.
Strong showing from Daniel Stranded.
Yeah.
It's not bad.